Now, Haiti in crisis. Political upheaval in the island nation prompted the Biden administration to allow Haitians in the U.S. to renew their protected immigration status. It reverses the Trump administration's efforts to end those protections. But as Yamiche Alcindor reports, anxiety about the future remains.
For months, the streets of Port-au-Prince, Haiti have been filled with protests. People gather often to demand that President Jovenel Moïse step down. They say he's increasingly acting like a dictator. These men chant, "Moïse is a thief." His critics say he took office under bad circumstances, but made them much, much worse.
Jovenel doesn't have any respect for the Constitution. You are a thief, Jovenel Moïse. You don't have respect for the Constitution.
Gangs have become more powerful. Kidnappings have skyrocketed and become more brazen, like this one caught on a church live stream. Civilian deaths are on the rise. People all over the island nation are terrified. They say even for a country that has long struggled, these past few months have felt like a new rock bottom. Even a notorious gang leader, Jimmy Chalizier, known as Barbecue, walks the streets freely, in his neighborhood hailed as a hero. Critics argue President Moïse is turning a blind eye to gangs at best, and at worst, colluding with them.
He destroyed the police. He is working with the gangs. So the insecurity of the people of Haiti as it is today, it is an insecurity driven by the state.
Pierre Esperance is the executive director of the National Human Rights Defense Network. He says the fear sweeping through Haiti today is unlike anything he has experienced.
What we are living through in Haiti, we have never experienced it before. Even when there was political instability, it was never like this.
Gang members develop strong ties with officials. And you cannot even attack those gangs because if they get in prison, they will be released because of strong connection they have to power.
Emmanuela Douillon is a leader of the youth protest group Nous Pas Dormir, which means we will not sleep. The group wants a transitional government to replace Moïse and organize the next elections.
We're not going to have zero corruption like tomorrow, but at least we can make sure that those who are involved in corruption really pay for what they are doing.
Moïse was elected in 2016, but didn't take office until the following year. He says his five-year term expires in 2022. Others, including civil leaders and clergy members, say he should have stepped down in February based on the Haitian Constitution.
We are here to tell the president that he has to admit he cannot continue to run the country and that his mandate is finished.
Earlier this year, Moïse dissolved parliament, saying most lawmakers' terms had ended. But he rejects the idea that he is on the same electoral timetable as parliament. Moïse also forced three Supreme Court judges into early retirement, an act criticized internationally as illegal. The president claimed the judges were becoming too political. One of them was seen as a potential opposition candidate to replace him. Meanwhile, Moïse also wants to change the Constitution by referendum, a move even members of his own party reject. The changes would give the president more power. The new constitution would abolish the prime minister role, seen as a check on presidential power. It would also temporarily protect the sitting president from impeachment or prosecution, and it would shrink the legislature. Moïse insists he will not run for a second term next year.
There is, in my opinion, an assault on democracy right now in Haiti.
Haitian native Catherine Buteau says her family were victims of Moïse's power grab. She says her parents, a surgeon and a career bureaucrat, are politically outspoken, but not formally part of the opposition. But in the middle of the night on February 7th, presidential palace guards dragged them from their beds. Along with Catherine's aunt and 14 others, they were accused of plotting a coup.
They genuinely thought that they were going to die that day.
When the NewsHour spoke to Buteau, her parents had been in prison for 6 weeks.
My parents, whose only crime, I guess, is to just be concerned citizens, are in prison. And people who have conducted massacres, who have conducted killings, are freely, are you know, sort of living freely in Haiti with no arrest, nothing.
Buteau's relatives were released on March 26, but she said their arrest was a sign of Moïse's growing authoritarianism.
The fact that this happens only sort of reflects a sort of a dictatorship that is growing.
Moïse's opponents say his actions recall the repression of Haiti's past. The nation was ruled by François Duvalier, known as Papa Doc, and then his son Jean-Claude, or Baby Doc, for almost 30 years. It was a period of human rights abuses and corruption. Esperance says the situation under Moïse is actually worse.
What's different is the fact that under Jovenel's regime, he has destroyed all of the institutions.
The U.S. says it believes the peaceful transition of power helps strengthen democratic institutions and has sided with Moïse. But Moïse's opponents say Biden is breaking campaign promises he made to Haitian Americans when he was courting their votes last year.
There's clearly no quit in the Haitian community. There is none. And I promise you there'll be no quit on my part as your president.
These protesters were calling for closer alignment with Russia, brandishing the Russian flag. One was questioned about Biden's promises.
What promise? I'm going to tell you something. As long as the American government has gone up, made changes, gone down, they have always made Haiti dozens of promises, yet none has ever been executed.
The people of Haiti and the Haitian community in the United States are very disappointed by the Biden administration's politics.
It's an opinion shared by younger Haitians like Emmanuela Douillon.
And we are afraid that the same thing that happened under the Duvalier might happen now, that the U.S. will close their eyes and let Jovenel Moïse do whatever he wants. And years later, they will recognize that they could have acted better in Haiti, but it will be too late.
For the Haitian government's perspective, I spoke with Haitian ambassador to the U.S., Bouchit Edmond.
What do you say to critics who say that the insecurity in Haiti is a direct failure of the Haitian government?
I don't think so. It's not a direct failure of the Haitian. Those are results of many years of bad governance. And, you know, unfortunately, the Moïse administration now today has inherited that, but he has to deal with it.
And you said that President Moïse, he inherited this insecurity, but when I talk to people, they say never in their lives has the situation in Haiti been this bad. You have gangs controlling large swaths of the country. What do you make of critics who say this government is allowing gangs to act with impunity and maybe even aligning with some gangs?
Yeah, but that would be an opinion, because everybody knows in Haiti, the gangs, most of them, they have patrons. They have people behind them. It's not government issues. It's also a private sector thing, because some private sector members, they do have control over some gangs as well.
The biggest criticism, I think, of President Moïse is that he's leading Haiti toward a dictatorship, that he's acting like a strong man. What do you make of critics who say that?
There is no dictatorship in Haiti, and those people, they really know what dictatorship means, and they are not under dictatorship, because when there was dictatorship in Haiti, even the fact to question or to mention dictatorship would have been a violation.
President Moïse, he declared that the mandates of the lower houses and senators had ended, but that his term would go 5 years day to day. I wonder why some critics would say he's counting his days differently than those in Parliament.
Let me clarify that for you. President Moïse did not dissolve Parliament, like some people are saying, I'm repeating. But the Parliament terms expired. It is clearly said in the Constitution, President is elected in Haiti for 5 years. And 5 years start February 7, 2017.
Talk to me about the arrest on February 7th. There are people who say those people are political prisoners. I know that they're also accused, of course, of planning a coup d'etat. What do you make of people who say they're political prisoners?
The first thing I will tell them, they are not political prisoners. They are not. The second thing is, those people, they were involved in the plot.
Why do you think that elections are possible, especially with all this insecurity? There are people who say gangs controlling large swaths of the country are going to make it impossible for the government or candidates to campaign.
We cannot put the country on a hold saying that conditions are not met, we cannot have elections, and while the government has a responsibility to hold those elections and to make sure elected officials are being replaced by elected officials. Because we need to stop the cycle of transition.
Do you think that it will hurt the democracy of Haiti if after the elections, a large number of people, including civil society, don't see the elections as credible?
Listen, this is what we, unfortunately, we have seen for the last 25 years since we've been, even more than that, since we started to enter in a democratic process. Elections in Haiti are always contested. You even have people who get 1% of the vote, and they say that they stole their votes.